Thank you. Please be seated. Well, good morning. And on behalf of the board, the staff, and faculty of PRBI, we welcome you here. Students, parents, grandparents, family, friends, and all of those who are joining us online this morning for the graduation ceremony of 2023. Let us hear Jesus' words from the Sermon on the Mount, Matthew chapter 6, verses 33 to 34. But seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well. Therefore, do not worry about tomorrow, for tomorrow will worry about itself, for each day has enough trouble of its own. Graduation is a day to look back on foundations, and in your case, graduates, to look back on the foundation you have been building on God's kingdom and on his righteousness. But it's also a day to celebrate, and we celebrate your growth in Christ, your growth in character and in equipping for the service in God's kingdom. But graduation is also a time to look to the future, not a worry-filled future, but one hopeful and one built on the unshakable kingdom of God and Christ. And so we gather today to celebrate what you've accomplished, what God has accomplished in you, and we celebrate with you and anticipate with you what he will do in and through your lives in the months and years ahead. And so we want to ask God's blessing on our ceremony today. Jason Gayway, our chair of our pastoral department, is going to come and lead us in prayer.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we are in awe of your magnificent power displayed through the entire universe. For through you all things were made and all things have their being. And we come before you with grateful hearts and with thanks and long to adore you and worship only you. We pray that as your word is spoken today, it would not return void. And that as our students go out from here into the world, they would bring your light into it for your glory. Bless us today, God, with your joy for the way you have helped these grads get to this place and gratefulness that you have shown us this year. You set David upon a rock in the midst of his enemies, and you have done the same for us. Psalm 62:8, trust in him at all times, O people. Pour out your heart before him. God is a refuge for us. Amen.
Would you stand together and let's sing a song of worship together?
Our song shall rise to thee.
seated. Sorry, that's me again. The class valedictorian is chosen on the basis of Christian character, academics, and PRBI involvement, with the last receiving a slightly greater consideration. This year's valedictorian is Alana Lindberg. Alana is from Burns Lake, BC. She is graduating with her three-year Bachelor of Biblical Studies degree. Her cumulative GPA is 3.29. Alana has demonstrated a desire to know God and His Word and is a diligent student of the Scriptures. After graduating with an Associate of Christian Studies diploma in 2022, she decided to return to PRBI for a third year in order to grow even more in her knowledge and relationship with God. Alana has a heart for discipling young women. She served as a community life group leader in her second year and led a discovery Bible study group in her third year. Alana's passion for discipleship extends beyond her school experience, and she desires to keep discipling others after PRBI as God provides opportunity. We pray that God will enable her to encourage, mentor, and guide others towards maturity in Christ wherever He leads her. Alana is also a hands-on, behind-the-scenes servant. During her time here, she served for two summers at Bear Lake Bible Camp as an assistant cook and has been a valuable part of the PRBI kitchen crew. Her gift and love of service enables her to be a quiet yet strong team player and leader who serves with excellence. Congratulations, Alana, for being named this year's class valedictorian.
Thank you all for being here today to celebrate this year's graduation with us. For some of us, it's the end of our time at PRBI. It's hard to believe that we have been here so long already and that our time here is up. Looking forward to the future is a scary thing, and one thing that I am grateful for is that we don't have to do this alone. As we leave our lives at school behind and go into the world, the question we are probably all asking is, what should we do next? For so many of us, all we have known for the last 2, 3, or even 4 years is life at school, living in a community with other Christians. Now the next step is learning how to live away from that school and going back into the secular world and work world. As we do this, I first want to remind you to stay connected, stay in touch with each other, with your other Christian friends, and gather a group of people around you who will encourage you, build you up, and help strengthen your walk with God. We might be leaving the school, but God gave us the church for a reason, so that we can stand together in a world with completely different values from our own. While I'm on the topic of community, I want to thank those of you who have been a part of our being here. First, I want to thank all of our friends and family who have given up the time that they could have had with us. It's not an easy thing to have someone in your family leave for somewhere else and not see them very often. But giving us the freedom to leave and go to school has brought so much growth and experience to all of us. I also want to thank everyone who has put their life into work at PRBI and making our school here possible. For the teachers, you have put so much work into making our time here learning the best that it can be. We have all learned so much because of all you have done for us and grown so much more than we would have without you to teach us. For all the rest of the staff, you've put so much effort into building into our lives, taking time out of your already busy schedules to be free to talk with us and work with us at whatever place we're at. And it has benefited each one of us in unique and personal ways. So as we move away from this community, I want to encourage each of my fellow grads to reach out so that those close to you can help you through the hard times and be excited with you through the good times. It is so easy to lose track of friends once school is done and life outside it begins. But it is so essential to keep them close so you have someone to help build you back up. Second, as we move forward in different directions, I want to remind you all to continually turn to God. Life is unpredictable, but there's one thing that we can be certain of in the face of uncertainty, and that is God is with us. We see Joshua learn this in Deuteronomy 31:6 as he goes to cross the Jordan with the people of Israel. He is told, "Be strong and courageous. Do not be terrified or afraid. For the Lord your God is the one who will go with you. He will not leave you or abandon you." So in those times that life goes so fast that you feel like you can't see what happened or where it is going, take courage and remember that God is with you. In those times that God is giving you good things and everything is great, rejoice in the Lord and be thankful. The reason that I've gotten to where I am is because of God. I would have not been able to do it myself. Psalm 18:2 says, "The Lord is my rock, my fortress, and my deliverer, my God, my rock, in whom I take refuge." God is the one that protects us when life beats us down. God is the one that gives us strength to get back up again. He's the reason that we can find strength to finish a class presentation only to start working on an 8-page paper due the next day. God is the reason that I even came back to school for a second and a third year in the split-second decision of listening to that small voice saying I needed to go back. We may not know what the future looks like or how the events of the past will affect the future, but God does. God is the solid rock that we can stand on in times when life takes every turn possible and tries so hard to throw us off balance. God's guiding is the best guiding that we could ever receive, and we only need to be open to listening for it when it comes. I have a saying that I discovered recently that helps to explain my time here at PRBI. That is, life is a smoothie and time is the blender. What I mean by this is the way that time takes all of the things that have happened and all of the memories that we make, and it mixes them together. Some things stand out, but for the most part, it becomes hard to separate everything that happens. This saying helped me to realize something from my time here. Everything that we do, all of the memories of fun times and the memories of crazy or hard times mixed together, they become what our life is currently and are the essence of who we are. Everything that we have done in our time here is important. And even if things start to blur together and we can no longer distinguish the different parts of our lives, it all works together to make us who we are as people and who we are in Christ. God uses every little thing that happens. He uses it to shape us into who we will become in the future. Everything that we do and everything that happens matters. Life is full of ups and downs that shape us into who we are. No matter how big or small, God can use everything that you are and everything that you do. As Paul was sure in Philippians 1:6, "I am sure of this, that he who started a good work in you will carry it on to completion until the day of Christ Jesus."
A scripture reading is from Psalm 37, verses 1 to 7, to 9. "Do not fret because of evil men, or be envious of those who do wrong. For like the grass, they'll soon wither. Like the grass plants, they will soon die away. Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and enjoy safe pastures. Delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord. Trust in him, and he will do this. He will make your righteousness shine like the dawn, the justice of your cause like the noonday sun. Be still before the Lord and wait patiently for him. Do not fret when men succeed in their ways, when they carry out their wicked schemes. Refrain from anger and turn from wrath. Do not fret. It leads only to evil, for evil men will be cut off, but those who hope in the Lord will inherit the land."
Our graduation speaker this morning is Josh Rigby. He's an alumnus of PRBI, and he has served as our Dean of Men for the past 2 years. Josh also teaches 2 courses and coaches our drama team, Earthen Vessels. Somewhere in there, he finds time to be a husband to Megan and dad to Hadassah and Joel. Josh brings his pastoral ministry and gifts, pastoral ministry experience and his gifts to his student life position. His friendly demeanor, his listening ear, his wise counsel suit him well and have equipped him well for this role with the students. It's no surprise then that the grads have requested that Josh be our speaker. He was supposed to be our speaker last year, but unknown and uncertain family issues came up, and so we're really pleased, Josh, that you can be here this year, and we look forward to what you have to say. So please welcome Josh Rigby.
PRBI grads of 2023, you made it. Some of you are sitting here in the calm assurance, knowing that one day you would arrive as a graduate of Peace River Bible Institute. Some of you are in a haze, amazed that you're here. Still others of you are wondering if we missed something, and if you really should be here. Nevertheless, you're here. You made it, and you're moving on to what God has for you next. So as we think about that idea of moving on to what God has for you next, I want to leave you an encouragement from the Word of God. But first, let's pray. Father, we come before you, and we praise you that you are the God who knows the past, the present, and the future. You are the God in whom we can trust and who invites us to delight in you and that you will give us good things. Father, I pray that for each one of these graduates, that you would show us and show them as they step forward what it means to delight in you and that you would be glorified in their lives. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. Delight yourself in the Lord. Enjoy him. Be refreshed in his presence. Psalm 37, verse 4. But as you have learned by now, to take a verse and not to look at its context is equal to a vile crime. So let's look at the surrounding verses, starting at verse 3, and we'll read to verse 5. And it says this, trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and cultivate faithfulness. Delight yourself in the Lord and he will give you the desires of your heart. Commit your way to the Lord. Trust also in him and he will do it. First call of this passage that we read is the call to trust. Specifically to trust in the Lord. Not to become distracted by all that goes on around you in the world, to be thrown off by what could have, should have, or ought to have been, but to remain steadfast, trusting in the Lord. Graduate, as you move on from school, may the work that you have done here to trust in the Lord in spite of circumstances, in spite of what others are doing, may that continue. Take rest and dwell where he has placed you, and cultivate faithfulness, or work diligently in doing what is right and good and honorable in our God's sight. We come to the main verse of this passage, delight yourself in the Lord, and he will give you the desires of his heart. And I want to ask you, graduate, is that something that you desire? To find delight in our God. Delight is a strong word. To find delight in something to be overcome with awe and wonder. And to be comforted and to enjoy something. To be that kid on Christmas morning who opens up the present only to find out it's exactly what they wanted in fresh new packaging just for them. The illustration falls short, but I think we can see that face of the child in awe. With delight upon their face. The look of delight to find great joy in the Lord. I believe this is something that you want. And I would ask you this. Are you there? Have you arrived at delighting in the Lord? I hope by now in your studies you've got past thinking you've arrived and you've realized that as finite humans, we are blessed by the infinite God. But we should never think that we have grasped or understand all there is to know about him. So how do we move towards this? How do we move towards this delight in the Lord? First of all, I think we can say with confidence it will not happen by accident. You are not likely to drift towards this. You will need to make it your goal, your focus, which is exactly where verse 5 leads us. Commit your way to the Lord. Trust also in him, and he will do it. This starts right at the beginning of your walk with Jesus Christ. It starts by committing your life to him. For most of us in this room, this is a step that we have taken. But maybe for some of you in this room, you never have done this. You have never thought about the reality that sin is a barrier to God and it demands justice to be done. That the love of God is not some nice principle or story. It is something to be personally accepted by us. That we need to humble ourselves before our God and ask forgiveness for our sins. And then as 1 John 1:9 states, that he is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. And that's possible because of the love that God has for us, that he would send his one and only son to pay the penalty for my sins and for your sins on the cross, and then to show his power over sin by rising from the dead. And then scripture is clear that if we accept this and believe this, we are saved from the penalty of our sins. I would say that most of you in this room have taken this step. If you haven't, I would encourage you to ask questions of our graduates or myself or someone else. It's a very important step. But it's the first step, graduates. Commit your way to the Lord. It is not the last step. Scripture refers to the step as being born again. Again, typically birth does not signify the end of something, rather the beginning. And this is where I challenge you, graduates, alumni, friends, and family. How are you doing with following through with this step? That step that once said, I commit my life to the Lord. Committing all your ways to the Lord. Have you willingly chosen, graduate, to commit your future, your finances, your relational status, your career, your resources, your everything to him? To say, I am a steward of the Most High. I am not the master of my own domain. Rather, I am the one who answers to the Lord, the one who has committed my way to him. Will you commit to this and then choose to, as the end of our verse says, to trust in him and he will do it. To say, my God, I believe. To leave the results and the timing up to him. To trust something completely is to abandon all other options. To rest solely on the thing that you trust. You cannot trust something completely and have a backup plan at the same time. Either you are trusting or you are not. And I believe that God doesn't want partial trust in him. He wants our complete trust with no backup plan, but a childlike submission to him and to his plan. And graduate, I believe that it's in this state, in this posture, we will learn what it really means to delight in the Lord. As we close, I want to read a poem for you by an author unknown, but revised by Chris Field. And graduate, may this be your prayer. Lord, I am willing to receive what you give me, to lack what you keep from me, to relinquish what you take from me, to surrender what you claim from me, to suffer what you ordain for me, to do what you command of me, and to wait until you say to me, go. Graduate, may this be your desire, to delight yourself in the Lord, allowing him to give you the desires of your heart, committing your way to him, and trusting in him. Amen.
Been a year marked by the Lord's provision. That is what I say when I'm asked about the current school year. I say it's been a year marked by the Lord's provision the Lord provides. Not only have we seen a significant increase in enrollment this year over last year, but the Lord has provided tremendously in other critical areas, including an estate gift, reduced insurance costs, a good spirit among our students, a sold-out youth alert, over 700 to our performing arts showcase, tremendous donation totals at Christmas in February and at the showcase, and seasonally high application numbers for the fall, among so many other things. Another really distinct way the Lord has provided, at least for one of our married students, was that in the student's words, God introduced learning as fun again. God introduced learning as fun again. I was struck by the statement and for the Lord's provision in this particular student's life. Praise the Lord for his many provisions. The Heavenly Father has been so faithful and so good to us. Another provision is that we have a shop facility coming this summer. If you wander outside the back, even this morning, you'll see the shell of the building in place. And this image gives a little bit more of the finished product. This building will significantly help us with our maintenance needs on campus. In the fall, we have another outdoor concert coming up, and it kind of kicks off our year, and we've done this a couple times now, and this year we'll have a group called Manic Drive. This is a family and youth group event for all ages, food trucks, inflatables, live music, and social connections will be had that night, so you won't want to miss it. Tickets will go on sale in the summer, and they'll be about $10 each, so we hope to see you there. We have another opportunity to join the alumni choir. We've done one round of this, and this would be for alumni singers ages 19 to 99. And with 99, I said, with PRBI's 90th birthday coming, we want to be ready for that, and we want to assemble another group for that. So this round of rehearsals will start September 13th. It'll be roughly 10 weeks leading up to a November performance. So if you're interested, watch for those advertisements or contact the college. We have our 90th birthday coming up. 90 years ago, a grand vision of a Bible college in our area was put on the hearts of many families in our region. Together, they built a wonderful school that trained kingdom servants, and we want to celebrate that together. We already have the service plan, believe it or not. We just need you to come and to invite your fellow alumni to come. It'll be November 24th and November 25th, a 7 o'clock service and a 2:30 service. It'll be the same service both days, so just choose the one that works best for you. And more information will be coming out in the coming months. You won't want to miss that one either. And then a whole year from now, almost, is our Performing Arts Showcase, and we're excited about that. You can see the dates on the screen, and we'd love to have you come join us for this event as well. We thought we'd better get the dates out early, because some of us plan that far ahead. So we had 700 out last year, and we're hoping to have just as many or more, or this year, and we hope to have just as many or more next year. As you have heard, it's been a great year. And one that's been marked by the Lord's provision. The exciting part is that we get to do it all over again in the fall with a new group of students. And that doesn't happen without partnership together in this kingdom work. So would you consider partnering with us in prayer and giving today? Let's pray. Father in heaven, today is a special day, a day that we can rejoice with these graduates for the accomplishments that they have achieved and for the work they've completed. Would you bless these graduates richly today? Help them to continue to seek you with all their hearts, not straying from your commands. Would they hide your word in their heart and rejoice in following your statutes, meditating on your precepts and considering your ways all the days of their life? Lord of the harvest, it's also a day that reminds us to pray, to ask you to send out workers into your harvest field. And together we ask you, the Lord of the harvest, to do just that, to send out workers into your harvest field. Lord, you are the giver of all good gifts, and today we ask that you would continue to provide for PRBI in the years to come. Bless the giver and the gift, we pray. Amen. As the offering is being received, we are going to acknowledge the scholarship, bursary, and award recipients via video. Thank you for your generous support of these students.
Bailey Bienert receives the Dave and Muriel Anderson Diligence Bursary. Dustin Blackmore receives the Grandpa Jack Summer Ministries Bursary and the Foster's Seed and Feed Academic Scholarship for being the junior with the second highest average. Silas Brunham receives the Emily McGilvery Bursary and the Jackie Whitehouse Memorial Bursary. Elena Corpus receives the Croker Education Foundation Bursary and the Terry and Marcy Belisky Performing Arts Bursary. Katrina Dirksen receives the Harold Gustafson Memorial Missions Bursary. Tina Dirksen receives the Landis Family Bursary for transferees and foreign students. Beth Ann Dreger receives the Bear Lake Bible Camp Bursary, the Croker Education Foundation Bursary, and the Aussie Aislesen Leadership Award. Jalen Emmons receives the Terry and Marcy Belisky Church Ministries Bursary. Sean Esau receives the Croker Education Foundation Bursary and the E.S. Williams Academic Scholarship for having the highest average among the sophomores. Bethany Fair receives the Student Leadership Award. Rory Fair, the Croker Education Foundation Bursary, and Samantha Fair, the Robert Paris Memorial Bursary, and the Freshman Academic Scholarship for having the highest average among the freshmen. The Edna and Murray Downey Bursary, as well as the Terry and Marcy Belisky School Spirit Award, is presented to Garrett Friesen. Carmen Friesen receives the Henry and Mary Siebert Memorial Bursary. Talisa Gibbard receives the Woodford Bursary, and Bryce Giesbrecht, the Aaron and Joan Sawatsky Memorial Bursary and the Alice Zakowski Paris Bursary. Tyra Giesbrecht receives the Woodford Bursary, Logan Gurnett, the Evangelism Bursary, Brian Hagerman, the Walter and Irene Peters Memorial Bursary, and Chloe Kaut, the North Pacific Crescent Bursary. Hannah Clausen receives the Landis Family Missions Bursary, the Foster's Seed and Feed Academic Scholarship for being the freshman with the second highest average. Poncho Clausen receives the Cram Family Jeremiah 29:13 Bursary and the Jackie Whitehouse Memorial Bursary. Carrie Jansen receives the Croker Education Foundation Bursary and the Terry and Marcy Belisky School Spirit Award. Alana Lindberg receives the Brian Barrett Memorial Bursary, as well as the Walter and Irene Peters Memorial Bursary. Chance Nesbitt receives the Giesbrecht Family Bursary, and Wilma Peachy, the Robert Paris Memorial Bursary. Jonas Plett receives the Cram Family Jeremiah 29:13 Bursary, as well as the Student Leadership Award. Justine Pouliot receives the Croker Education Foundation Bursary, the Terry and Marcy Belisky Christian Sportsmanship Award, and for having received the second highest average among the sophomore, the Landis Family Academic Scholarship. Micah Redekop receives the Chester Thronis Memorial Bursary, Paige Reed, the Drama Ministries Bursary, as well as the Terry and Marcy Belisky Performing Arts Bursary. Bryson Reimer, the Aaron and Olive Gortz Memorial Bursary, the Croker Education Foundation Bursary, and the Aussie Aislesen Leadership Award. Caden Reimer receives the Croker Education Foundation Bursary and the Landis Family Mission Bursary. Chrissy Reimer receives the Bear Lake Bible Camp Bursary and the Croker Education Foundation Bursary. Sadie Reimer receives the Landis Family Associate of Christian Studies Bursary. Jillian Russell receives the Summer Ministries Bursary. Kayla Schock, the Stridehorst Bursary. Rachel Schoenberger, the Summer Ministries Bursary. Janaea Schultz receives the Terry and Marcy Beliski Church Ministries Bursary. Eli Siemens, the Brian Barrett Memorial Bursary. Brooklyn Sorensen, the Giesbrecht Family Bursary. Callista Lorenz, the Abe and Mary Olfert Memorial Bursary. Matthew Stobe receives the Amanda Clausen Memorial Bursary, the McRae Land Development Bursary, and the Junior Academic Scholarship for being the junior with the highest academic average. Nathan Trudeau receives the Johnston Family Heritage Bursary, the McRae Land Development Bursary, and the Terry and Marcy Beliski Christian Sportsmanship Award. Jocelyn Turin receives the Jubilee 93 Anniversary Bursary, and Eugene Weeb, the Married Student Bursary, Mature Student Bursary, and the Ronald C. Lovett Memorial Bursary. Thank you to all our donors and supporters for your generosity to our students, and congratulations to all our student recipients.
Yes, we cannot do this without your partnership, as you see from all of those bursaries and scholarships. And well done, students, for your part in some of those scholarships or awards that you earned and other bursaries that you applied for. So we're grateful for that. We also, every year, honor a worthy alumnus, and the board of directors chooses someone from within our alumni group, former staff or board members, men or women who have made a great contribution to the work of Jesus Christ. And this year we are honoring Larry Duick with this award, and I'm going to invite Larry and his daughter, Melissa Finley, to join him on the stage here with me. I draw your attention, as they make their way here, to Larry's bio in your program. I encourage you to read it at your leisure. But what impressed me about Larry's bio is that Larry was one of those students who just wouldn't leave PRBI. And we can be thankful that he stayed connected. Larry transitioned from a student into a builder, and his fingerprints are all over this campus, as you can see by the extensive list in his bio. All of these buildings required a lot of hard work to construct. But don't be fooled, Larry had a moment or two of fun doing this as well. He shared one incident that didn't make it into your program that I thought was worth passing on. Larry wrote, "In 1976, we built the chapel building. It's now called Watts, the building on the north side of our campus here. The basement was dug about 4 feet deep, and the footing forms were made ready for concrete. A new 8-yard mixer arrived with a full load of concrete. And as the driver backed up and ready to start the pour, he stood on the fender to control the operations from there. When he revved up the engine, the truck lurched backwards and landed in the middle of the basement." Crisis. We removed our forms where the ramp was and quickly pulled the truck out. Larry writes, "I grabbed my camera to take a picture, but the driver requested no pictures, please." With tongue in cheek, Larry says he must have had his reasons. But after all, it's not every day that big trucks go to chapel. But even though Larry's been a builder with his hands, you'll note in his bio, it's about people. It's about the people that invested in his life, and he has quite a list there. And so, Larry, as PRBI presents you with this award, we do so in recognition of your legacy in our buildings, but more importantly, your investment in the people who have benefited from the training in God's Word because they had classrooms to go to, faculty and staff that had offices to work from, and students had a place to call home while they stayed here on campus. And so we want to say thank you and congratulations, Larry, for a well-deserved award.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And what a pleasure it is for me to be here today. And I gratefully and humbly accept the honor as the Alumnus of the Year, knowing too well that the committee could have chosen any number of my countless fellow alumni. PRBI has always run very deeply in my veins since my wife and I packed up our little family over 50 years ago to come and attend the institution of my choice. By the way, this is my daughter, Melissa, who may well have to step in if my voice gives out, which it is prone to do since my cancer treatments. Incidentally, Missy also holds this prestigious title as PRBI graduate after squeezing a 3-year degree into 6 long years. I thought, what could be the reason for this? And it occurred to me that I spent 7 years between studies and work here on campus, maybe like father, like daughter. PRBI has equipped me for life in numerous different areas. In fact, everything I do ultimately has been influenced because of the time I spent here. Okay. Sorry.
No. Whether it be serving on boards, running a business, leading small groups, or sharing my faith one-on-one, I find myself drawing on the knowledge, wisdom, and commitment passed on by my faithful instructors. The PRBI family is family for life. The friends I made here continue to inspire and encourage me to this day. They are some of the people who supported me so well as I just had to say goodbye to my dear wife Elaine last June. The community here is priceless, and I am forever grateful. I would be amiss if I did not mention Oswald and Ruth Thrones, who took Elaine and I under their wings to validate, mentor, and teach us their view of eternal values. It was under Mr. Oswald Thrones' leadership that I was hired after my first year of PRBI school to oversee the rebuilding program of the campus. My experience thus far has mostly been in building entry-level homes. In retrospect, and from what I read in Scripture, leaders are often trained on the job. Examples are Moses, Joshua, and King Solomon. By no means was my assignment to be compared to theirs, but I believe the principle holds. What the Lord needs from us typically comes in two short words. When he lays his hand on our shoulders, he wants to hear, "Yes, Lord." Let me make one thing clear. I was not enticed to rebuild the campus with high wages. Sorry, I didn't mean to laugh, but I just did. At the time, all of us as staff, faculty, and support just shared what your parents and grandparents donated in terms of meat, produce, and donations. I'd like to share a little story from my time here. In my second year, we learned to rely on the Lord for everything. One morning, my wife informed me that we were out of milk and money. Maynard, our sweet baby boy, that's Maynard. Can you give him a wave, Maynard? That's him. would soon wake up and need his bottle of milk. Elaine and I held hands and prayed something like this. Lord, we only have 17 cents to our name. You know that we paid 22 cents for a quart of milk. I told Elaine that I would share this challenge with my 3 study mates and then be back for breakfast. When I arrived at the study room, no one was there, but an envelope with my name on it was on my desk. One of them had left a $5 bill with a note saying that the Lord laid it on his heart last night to share part of his school bus driving wages with us. See how the Lord really answered us before we had asked him for it? How we rejoiced over his immediate answer to prayer, as well as so many others along the way. Graduates, congratulations. My fellow alumni, I want to encourage you to continue to support this incredible institution. We need you. Maintain the relationships you have made in your time here, and you will need us. And most importantly, do look to God for everything you need. He is who and what we all need the most. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Larry. This year, the Peace River Bible Institute is graduating 18 students. In a moment, the 2023 graduates will be receiving their diplomas and degrees. After receiving these, they will proceed down the stairs over there to your left and pause in front of the backdrop there for a moment. If you do want to take pictures, you're welcome to just slip over into the front couple rows over there. You can follow along in your program to know the order that the graduates will be receiving their degrees. So feel free to slip over there if you want to take a picture. You can also do something after the conclusion of our grad as well. And so, without further ado, we will confer the degrees and diplomas. So, Mr. President, I would like to recommend the following candidates to be presented with the Associate of Christian Studies Diploma. Cody Dick, Bow Island, Alberta. Sean Bradley Esau, Clayhurst, BC. Rory Elizabeth Fair, Dawson Creek, BC. Talisa Esther Marie Gibbard, Saskatoon, Saskatchewan. Bryce Russell Giesbrecht, Vanderhoof, BC. Carrie Jansen, Holden, Alberta. Graduating in absentia, Natalie Lorraine Jennings, Peterborough, Ontario. Montana Joy Quill, Hinton, Alberta. Caden Alfred Reimer, Vanderhoof, BC. Jillian Grace Russell, Meadow Lake, Saskatchewan. And Micah Elizabeth Schultz, Lac La Biche, Alberta. By the authority vested in us by the Province of Alberta, the Board of the Peace River Bible Institute, and upon the recommendation of faculty, I present to you the following candidates for the Bachelor of Biblical Studies or Bachelor of Religious Education degrees to receive their degrees with all the rights and honors appertaining thereto. Mr. President, I would like to recommend the following candidates for the conferral of the Bachelor of Biblical Studies. Bailey Grace Beanert, Grand Prairie, Alberta. Carmen Rachel Friesen, Lacrete, Alberta. Alana Lindberg, Burns Lake, BC. Karen Shirley Ratzliff, Little Smoky, Alberta. Chrissy B. Reimer, Sexsmith, Alberta. Janaea Patricia Schultz, Lac La Biche, Alberta. Mm-hmm. Mr. President, I would like to recommend the following candidate for the conferral of the Bachelor of Religious Education with a major in Pastoral Ministries, Nathan Daniel Trudeau, Sexsmith, Alberta. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the graduating class of 2023.
Good morning. It's an honor to be here. There's been lots of board members over the years, probably got to pray over their grad class when they had a student graduating, but probably not many that got to pray over their spouse's grad class, so thank you, Kim. And I just thank you for everyone that came here this morning to support the grads and the school. It means a lot to help them get here, your financial support, your prayer support, and just the encouragement that it takes along the way, because sometimes the work is hard. They put a lot of effort into the papers they write and the amount of books they have to read, and on behalf of the board, we just want to thank you for all that you do for them. And I want to take just a moment just to acknowledge the history, the vision that this school has had for a very long time. And one of the things that I love is the act of incorporation of this school. It was made official in 1947, an actual bill that came through the legislature. And the wording in there says, having as its object the conduct of a Bible college, the training of students in a thorough knowledge of the Word of God, the Holy Scriptures, and the training of students to become ministers, whether at home or abroad. And I just think that's an amazing identity for the school that it's had for so long. And as it says in your on the front page of the program, a Bible college for life. And the faculty here, in my eyes, truly do their best to make a connection with the grads. And we had a student panel a couple months or a month back, and one of the grads was talking about how he could come to the president's office. It was an open door to talk to him and to get that relationship and mentorship. And it means a lot. I remember when I was here and just the connection we could have with the staff. And in my eyes, it's second to none. And I'm so glad to bless these grads. And let's pray together. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord God, for Peace River Bible Institute and the work that you do here. Lord, through these facilities, through the staff, through the many assignments that the students are given, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, for each one of these students and the direction that you gave them to come here. The support and encouragement you gave them to persevere through the difficultest assignments, through the stacks of papers to write, Lord God, and we just thank you that you helped them to get here through the support of friends and family as well. Lord, and as they prepare to leave this place, In some ways, it's almost like Peter stepping out of the boat and onto the water, Lord God. It's uncertain, Lord God, but as it says in the first chapter of Joshua, be strong and very courageous, Lord God. I pray that these grads would keep their hearts and their minds fixed upon you and the things that you have taught them here through the studies, through their discussion times with friends and staff. Lord God, that they would remember who you have told them that they are, that they would cling to that identity, Lord God, when the waves come up, when the water looks rough and scary. Lord God, that you would just help them to fix their eyes upon you, that they would continue to draw their strength from you and live the victorious life that you've called them to, Lord Jesus, and that you would just bless them in their days and years of ministry ahead and their future lives with you, Jesus. We thank you for this time, Lord Jesus. We thank you for this class. In your precious and holy name we pray, amen.
Will you please stand and let's once again sing a song of our God's faithfulness. Remain standing for the benediction.
Following the benediction, we'll allow the grads to exit first, and they will position themselves out in the foyer so that if you want to congratulate them or give them greetings, you'll have the chance to do so. Well, grads, here we are. Our vision for you in inviting you onto campus was that every student would encounter Christ in ways that would transform their lives. But now, as you leave, we want you to fulfill the other part of our vision, and that is wherever Christ takes you, that you will energize your church and impact your world for his glory. And so go knowing that we continue to pray for you, but also go knowing that you are under the blessing of God and the blessing of his word. And hear this benediction from 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. May our Lord Jesus Christ himself and God our Father, who loved us and by his grace gave us eternal encouragement and good hope, encourage your hearts and strengthen you in every good deed and word. Amen. Go in God's grace.